I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right. And as I turn up the collar on my favorite winter coat, this wind is blowing my mind. I see the kids in the street with not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them need? A summer's disregard, a broken bottle top, and a one-man show. They follow each other on the wind, you know, 'cause they got nowhere to go. That's why no one got to know. I'm starting with the man in the mirror.
So I want to congratulate you, first of all, on taking on really big topics. I've seen a lot of really good research, and I'm glad that each of your projects includes an action plan, because it's one thing to study an issue. It's one thing to know a lot about it, and I believe you all are sort of mini experts in your fields, but I think it's that next step about taking action and working with other organizations and getting other people involved. And so I really want to congratulate you, and I look forward to your presentations. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Arjun, and my topic today is reducing hunger. I chose this topic for two main reasons. First, the impact of hunger is staggering and often overlooked. And second, this is an issue where even we, as kids, can take simple steps in our everyday life to help. Hunger has a long history. It is one of the earliest causes of mass extinction on Earth. And yet, even after thousands of years of advancements in science, technology, and lifestyle, hunger continues to plague so many of our fellow world citizens.
Hello, my name is Liam Elliott, and I am doing sea pollution for my topic, as you can see in the board behind me.
Did you know it takes 450 years for a plastic bottle to decompose, and it takes 600 for a fishing line? 14 billion pounds of trash is dumped into the ocean every year, and most of it is plastic.
My name is Aiden Moody, and the topic that I chose was space junk, as you can see behind me. I picked this topic because I've watched many documentaries on science, and a lot of them talked about space junk, and that showed me how big of an issue this is.
I chose this topic because I love animals and I want to try my best to save them.
Demand for wildlife and wildlife products are influenced by different lifestyle, cultures, and thinking. In Asia, specific organs or body parts of animals are used in traditional medicine and some to represent wealth.
Hi, I'm Laura Louise Bevan-Shiraz. I'm 9 years old, and ever since I began to read as a toddler, my godmother has called me Matilda because I eat books for breakfast as I'm ready to take on the world. But hang on, what's this? The average girl's self-esteem peaks at the age of 9 and then plummets. Yikes, that's not a helter-skelter I want to go on.
I'm Claymore. I am a 10-year-old fifth grader at the Harbour School. My GIC topic is oil pollution. I chose this topic because it affects many sea animals, including my favorite animal, jellyfish. The worst thing that could happen is that all the fish could die out and then most people in the world won't have anything to eat.
This is the main thing that struck me this morning, is you're learning to care, so that when you grow up, you will still care. And we need people who care on the planet to change things, to do things, to share this information. So thank you all for all your wonderful work.
My name is Valeria, and my topic is abandoned children.
In China, kids are being abandoned because they have one-child policy. One-child policy affects all the children born with any disabilities. Perfect children are desired and imperfect ones are abandoned because of one-child policy. Sometimes in China, parents leave their kids in hospitals and nurses leave them on streets.
This is a global issue because 47 billion animals are dying a year. If this increases, most of our everyday diets will be exhausted. Why I've chose this topic is because I love animals. I love them so much that as soon as I heard about animal welfare and slaughters, I've turned vegetarian.
Animals are housed in unbearably small cages. They live with fear, stress, disease, parasites, all for the sake of an unnecessary global industry that makes billions of dollars annually.
What I'm doing to help is I'm signing petitions, and I'm not wearing fur, and I'm telling all my friends and family also not to wear fur.
To help stop this problem, I have made a website where you can test your knowledge on identity theft. If you do the quiz there, you might learn something new. You can help by going on this website and telling other people about it.
This is an important topic because lots of people are getting stolen from and their lives are being ruined by.
It's important for us to help fix problems that lead to poverty so that more people have the opportunity to live a better, happier and healthier life. How many people are hungry and can't afford enough nutrition for their families? The United Nations has said that over 1 billion of the estimated 7 billion people on Earth are hungry and can't afford enough nutrition to live.
My name is Shereen Fosso. My topic is shark finning.
Did you know that 50 million or more sharks are killed a year? That's a lot of sharks, don't you think? Every hour we kill about 11,147 sharks. Did you know that 600 whale sharks are killed every year?
Hi, my name is Daniel Yang. My global issue is the impact on tobacco smoking on young people. Tobacco smoking is when tobacco is burned in cigarettes and the smoke is inhaled and released into the air. It's a global issue because a lot of people smoke, pollute the air, and severely damage their health.
I believe that you are a bunch of brightest minds which are ably nurtured by the THS. And also, I am sure that all the knowledge which you are getting from your devoted teachers in THS will definitely make you productive and successful world citizen.
Sea levels are rising because the polar ice caps and glaciers are melting due to global warming. The oceans are rising about 3.5 millimeters per year because of global warming. Why is this happening? The sea levels are rising because the oceans are getting warmer because of greenhouse gases. This warming is melting the polar ice caps.
Because it's an important topic because puppies are pretty much being killed and being tortured for profit. How would you like it if you were put into a cage and forced to breed and then...
With limited or no regulations of enforcement, puppy mills have no cleanup control. This means that dogs can be living in urine and feces for an indefinite period of time.
When a person takes drugs, it affects the way they think and they start to see things, which are illusions. It distorts their understanding of reality.
It's a global issue because lots of people around the world take drugs, sell drugs, and use drugs to abuse their children.
This topic is important to me because I like to play with trees instead of walking over their stumps. Earth is losing a lot of trees every day. That is why I want to help. These are the topics of deforestation I'm going to tell you about. What causes deforestation and where does deforestation affect the most? And a few more.
My name is Andrew Lee and my topic is on tsunamis.
Tsunamis are giant waves caused by earthquakes or volcanic eruptions under the sea. As the waves travel closer towards the land, they build up higher and higher heights as the depths of the ocean decreases.
Did you know that nearly 1 billion people entered the 21st century unable to read a book or sign their names? These people could not afford education. According to UNICEF, 22,000 children die each day due to poverty. Literally, that is about 900 lives every minute or 15 children in every second.
Hi, my name is Haram Lee. Climate change is a very serious problem, causing concerns
about rising sea levels and vanishing habitats for animals.
I picked climate change because I thought climate change was making a lot of problems, and it's been on the news for a long time, and I thought I should help.
I chose this topic because I think it is important for all of us to know what child abundance is and how big
the problem seafood
is.
Comes from the ocean.
Imagine if more parents than 2 million people and they all have their kids on streams. What if they can do
Be an activist. Let's make a difference.